Eric, what does Google's recent data tell you about how people are shopping? What are the trends?
Well, the biggest trend this year is that people are shopping online more than ever. And so shopping online, of course, isn't new. This isn't new behavior for Canadians, but it's accelerated during the pandemic. What we saw in the spring is that e-commerce had tripled during the early days of the pandemic, had tapered down and slowed a little bit, was doubled during the summer. And we believe this holiday season that for many retailers, e-commerce will be double what it was a year ago, as Canadians are shopping online more than ever. It's comfortable, it's safe, it's easy. I mean, that is the single biggest trend that we're seeing today.
What are some of those key word searches?
Well, I think, the first thing is that, I mean, Canadians want to feel really, we're spending a lot of time in our home. We're working from home and we're spending a lot of time in our homes with our families. So I think the first thing that we've seen here at Google is that people want to be really comfortable. So in the early days of the pandemic, that was hoodies and jogging pants. It's still hoodies and jogging pants, but people are looking for like UGG slippers and other things to make winter more comfortable as we're in the home. Canadians are looking for things to do. We're bored. So the new Xbox, the new PlayStation are both two of the hottest toys that we're seeing. Canadians are trying to find both new gaming systems. We're not going to restaurants as often as we were previously. So we're at home and we're cooking a lot for ourselves and for our family. So whether it's a new food processor, a new espresso machine, trying to bring that restaurant home or that coffee shop home, we're cooking more than ever in our home. And the other really interesting trend that we've observed is that Canadians are looking for gift cards more than ever. And so that is among the most popular gifts that we've seen this holiday season. About 40% of Canadians have said that they're more likely to buy gift cards for their friends and family than they were the year before. It's safe, it's easy. And so we're seeing more popularity for gift cards than ever before.
Tell us about Google Trends, which helps the retailers and then I guess consequently the consumers.
Well, I think retailers use trends to understand, at a really high level, like what products Canadians want to buy. So I think it helps retailers plan and stock the right inventory and items. It also helps them spot regional variations. So this has been really important during the pandemic. As most of Canada has entered into that second wave, we've observed some really interesting trends at the regional level. So Manitoba was probably ahead of the curve here and entered that second wave before others. They saw twice as much interest versus the national average for gift cards. Something like curbside pickup, which has become increasingly popular for retails. Manitoba was 14 times the national average. And same day delivery. Similarly, Manitoba saw a spike that was 3 times the national average. So whether it's trending products like gift cards or the ways that Canadians want to buy things, whether it's items arriving the same day or curbside pickup, we're seeing a lot of regional variation that's in part determined by COVID cases and restrictions imposed on stores during the holiday season.
How are the key word searches different this year versus last year? And of course, you had mentioned some of the more obvious ones because we've all been at the mercy of this pandemic.
Well, I think previously I touched on some of the categories that we've seen the biggest change year over year. Again, it's about Canadians wanting to be comfortable. We're cooking more. We're bored. Home improvement has seen a spike during the entire COVID period. So it started with people looking to dress up like a home office, like many looking for an office chair and an office desk. We spent more time in our backyards than we have previously during the summer. So we looked for patio furniture. And even this fall, which traditionally isn't the peak moment for home improvement, we've seen rising interest in laminate flooring, appliances, really anything to make the home more comfortable and more enjoyable than we have in years prior. So home improvement's actually another trend that I think is really, really interesting. And as I touched on previously, how to shop, more interest in people looking to buy things online, looking to get things immediately, as Canadians may be worried that items are out of stock or may not arrive in time. New ways of shopping. So historically, Canadians either bought online or went to a store. During the pandemic, we've seen a rise of this third way of shopping, which is curbside pickup, which is starting the purchase online, But going to the store to actually pick it up because it's more convenient, because we want to support local businesses, because we're sure that we'll get the item on time. So that dynamic between like online versus in-store versus, you know, in-store but curbside pickup is something that has changed dramatically over the last year.
We saw governments push buy local. Did that affect the near me search?
Well, it certainly did. We've seen a dramatic increase in people looking for businesses around them. I mean, I think it's a really interesting dynamic because on one hand, the big box stores and some of the biggest retailers are able to stay open. They're the ones that have invested the most heavily in e-commerce and the infrastructure in place to succeed during this moment over the last many, many years. So on one hand, they're very, very well positioned to succeed in terms of expertise and infrastructure. The restrictions imposed on government, frankly, favor a lot of big businesses. That being said, the other side of the coin is that people do want to support local businesses. I mean, that Home Depot or Canadian Tire or Lowe's near me, I mean, it is a local business, but it's a different kind of local business. But also like the tip, the Main Street, you know, near Bayview Avenue near me, or Queen Street, or many of the other large streets where people gravitate towards small and independent businesses. Canadians want to shop there more than ever to support those businesses during a really difficult time. I think that's also another reason why we've seen that surge in gift cards. You may not need something now, an item or even a meal at a restaurant, but you're buying those gift cards at stores and at restaurants, again, because you want to support the local businesses.
Sectors have seen such big shifts this past year. Something that would have taken years perhaps has manifested in the past couple of months. What have you seen?
Well, it's a great question. I mean, the reality is most predictions around the pandemic have been wrong from the beginning. So these are very, very difficult things to predict. That being said, I think, you know, e-commerce historically had been, call it 8 to 10% of total retail sales. Now, there, you know, the devil is in the details, of course. It's 8 or 10% of retail sales that includes gasoline, automotive sales, flowers for your garden, right? A lot of products that you can't buy online. Paint is another great example. It's very difficult, if not impossible, to buy paint online. So while the average may have been 8 to 10%, in many categories, whether it was apparel or electronics or books or even furniture, it's been much, much higher. So during the pandemic, I mean, I think you're right. We've seen probably 10 years of transformation in really just a few months. And I think we expect that to continue. So whether it's those categories that I mentioned where we've always seen strong adoption, electronics, books, apparel, Canadians will continue to buy those products in growing numbers online. But I think the really interesting thing to watch here in Canada is that many categories that were more nascent really accelerated during the pandemic. So something like grocery, right? Buying groceries online was very, very nascent here in Canada. We were behind virtually every other country, especially given our rate of online shopping and digital adoption here. But groceries specifically was behind. That, of course, has caught up as the retailers and the grocers have caught up in Canada. I think furniture is another example where maybe historically you thought, you know what, before buying a sofa, I want to sit on it, I want to look at it, I want to measure it in person. More and more we're seeing large items like furniture shift from stores to online, and we expect that to continue as you get comfortable making that first big different purchase online and not in a store, and it works out great for you, you're more likely to make similar purchases like that in new categories in the future.
What's your data telling you about the upcoming holiday season?
Well, I think so. I mean, there's no sign that, online shopping will slow. If not, if anything, it will accelerate as we get closer to the end of the holiday season where people want to get their gifts. So I know for many retailers and Canadians, fulfillment was a concern going into the holiday period. Would Canada Post and others be able to deliver all of these packages? I think Canada Post reported that they were delivering more packages in the early days of the pandemic than they had all of Black Friday and holiday season a year ago. But interestingly enough, I think a lot of retailers have been able to get all of their packages out, and there seems to be more confidence in the infrastructure than we thought. going in. So online shopping will continue as we have another few weeks left of the holiday season. I think that dynamic between big retailers and smaller retailers is definitely something to watch. Canadians are still shopping online, and just because Black Friday or Cyber Weekend or Cyber Monday ends doesn't mean that shopping ends. If anything, it's more of a beginning than an end. And so when we work with retailers here on the advertising side of Google, what we've observed is that conversion rates, so a consumer's propensity to buy from a retailer, remains very, very high and among the highest levels they see all year well after Cyber Monday. So there's probably another like 2 or 3 weeks left of strong online sales for Canadian retailers. And even as we get closer to Christmas and even Boxing Day, I mean, Boxing Day is not as big a shopping moment in Canada as it was many years ago. It's still an important day and still an important moment. What we've observed here at Google is that while there may be fewer shoppers shopping at that time, their value to the retailers, the amount that they spend with those retailers, is actually quite high. So it's a really important audience for retailers to capture as they close out their year.